So, do you know what they say when somebody sneezes? Yes. Well, I think it's so much better to say, you are so good looking. Because it actually makes you feel better. Hi, my name is Kundan Chabra. I'm the author of Experiencing Divinity, Sharing Awakening. Why I don't need you, but I want you around anyway. And why I have never paid for a first date and other stuff that will blow your mind.
And how would you describe his act?
One of his kind. Like, it's very rare. I've never seen it anywhere else. And anytime I have like new people coming over to watch, I always pull them in to say they'll never see this again in their life.
In my entire life, I've never paid for a first date. I have never bought a drink for a girl. My attitude has always been, why should I? Is it because she's got a nice pair of bosoms? Or a fine ass? Well, when it comes to lovemaking, those boobies are not much use without my touch. Thanks.
I would say he probably, like, got completely over himself and now he can say whatever he feels like saying.
What I like to think of as the perfect pickup line. Basically, when approaching a complete stranger, I think it's important to have a perfect balance of courage and consideration. So if you have too much courage, you come off as creepy or aggressive, and that's a turn off. But if you have too much consideration, on the other hand, you probably would not even approach the woman. Too much courage would be like going up to a random woman and saying, you know, hey, sexy, you know, would you like to have sex with me?
He's really confident, extremely confident. So that's a plus. And I didn't expect him to carry himself that way, I guess. So that's what really stood out to me. So he's very soft-spoken, I guess. Anybody who's soft-spoken, you don't expect them to even go on a stage or perform or speak their mind. So as soon as he was up there, he was just like,
so you would go and approach a woman and ask her a question like, excuse me, miss, but may I ask you a very personal question? And please, if this makes you uncomfortable in any way, just give me the finger and I'll leave you alone. Now, if she has a sense of humor, she would laugh and say yes, you know. And if she says no, you can just politely say, oh, thank you for your time and leave. And also, that's another thing, it's a good screening kind of thing too, where you screen women for sense of humor. If they have a sense of humor, they're usually heart-centered and more somebody that I would want to go out with.
Okay.
I wrote a lot of prayers too. And that's where some of the prayers that I wrote that gets people into altered states comes from. It's influenced by my own experiences. And I also went to a retreat 3 years ago called the Enlightenment Intensive. And I had a profound experience there when I knew who I really was.
Who are you, would you say?
I am love itself.
So why do you think he does what he does?
Either he has experience in doing it and he feels like what he has to say can really benefit people, or is he on the opposite side of the spectrum and would like to experience love and things like that he sees, he makes poems and stories out of them, so maybe he just
is doing it because to express himself. That's what why I'm here. That's why a lot of people are here.